Hi, Tamara. All right, I'm gonna do your 30-minute spiritual healing now. So, I really loved what you said in your email, and I think you summed it up really well in this paragraph. And I think a lot of us can really relate to some of the things you said. So, I'm just gonna read this paragraph and then we're gonna get started, okay? So, you say, "It's so hard to see the beauty within me. I do not love myself. I do not see the beautiful soul of love and light that I know I am. I also feel that there is no purpose for me or my life. I ask myself, why am I even here? Lost, sad, lonely, and not loving me. I struggle with life, yet I feel life is beautiful. I struggle to connect with my spirituality. How do I see the beautiful soul of love and light within me? How do I begin healing?" So, I can't wait to help you. I'm just gonna relax here. I'm gonna enter your spiritual atmosphere, and then we'll see what we can do to help you with this, okay? So I'm just gonna relax, and I want to pull into the very specific question that you have. How do I see the beautiful soul of love and light within me? How do I begin healing? So, I am looking. There's a glass window. It's tinted glass, and it's kind of obvious, like an oval, and it kind of projects inward towards me, this oval glass, and it's tinted. I'm looking out of it. It's sort of like a two-way glass, so I can't see what's on the other side, but the other side could potentially see me, so to speak. You're stuck inside of a box or a cube. And this oval, it's literally like a mirror shape, like an oval shape, but it sort of kind of comes towards you like this. And then it's tinted, so you're sort of looking through it, and there's nothing to be seen. And then now sort of stuck inside of like a cube box, like there's a detective gonna come and talk to you today, but it's just like a cube box. So a few quick details that enter into the scene. One is an airport is on the other side of this with airplanes that sort of land and take off. And then another detail that's important about this box that you're sort of stuck inside, you're stuck inside of a cube. It's a perfect cube, but it's like it's got brick on the inside. So it really does feel like kind of a risque sort of the detective's gonna come in and talk to you kind of room. And the outline of each brick is really deep. I mean, it is specific. I can see every single individual brick inside of this cube box that you are stuck inside of. There are no doors here in or out. There's only this sort of oval-shaped window and no really ability to see. However, there's an odd sensation as though on the other side of this, there's an airport with planes landing and taking off. I'm not necessarily feeling trapped though. I'm in contemplation. I'm really thinking right now, and I'm taking the time to actually really think about things. Not necessarily my emotions, the way I feel about something. I'm just pondering, thinking about things. And there's a patient sort of breathing way, taking the time to examine this odd sort of window, mirror. It's not a mirror, it's a window. Looking through the window, not really seeing anything. Thinking about airports all the time. Thinking about planes flying out and coming in. I'm now actually standing at an airport. I see you on the other side of the glass, and I'm on the outside where all the planes come in. I'm looking up at you. You're levels up above, but I can see you pressed against the glass. I see you as a younger girl, maybe 8 years old, sort of face pressed against the glass. I'm looking at you. You're looking down at me. There's not a lot in the way of communication. You're not sharing a lot with me, but there's nothing to be shared. It's sort of like a curious child that's just looking, you know? What are they actually thinking about, feeling about, just looking? However, they're downloading whole heaps of information without exactly realizing it. Something makes you feel singled out, as though there's people here, like family here, but you're not paying attention to anybody else. You're just, whatever it is that you choose to look at is what you are looking at. Very kind of instinctive, like a child in that way. Again, there's not in the way of, I feel sad inside, I feel happy, I feel, there's nothing to be felt. There's no reason to have a feeling necessarily. You are inspiring the manifestation of flowers to sort of be put. There's a pot manifesting and flowers growing within the pot and in the corner of this perfectly bricked interior. Starting to take on some kind of really sort of modern style East Coast apartment or something where there's sort of exposed brick and that sort of thing. It's sort of taking on that effect now. That window isn't really the focus, as the corner of the room is the focus with this pot on a stand and flowers. Thing is there is the reflection of flowers, and then there's the reflection of just an empty pot with soil, nothing growing. There's the potential that the pot falls and breaks, but now it is just becoming invisible as well. Now we have just like a plant stand. There's a kind of a sigh. There's no emotion. The cage is not rattled by the pot, you know, breaking or anything like that. And if this plant stand disappeared altogether, it wouldn't really matter. And there's no real feeling of loss about this. It just really feels like it doesn't matter. You are now standing out in the middle of where planes come and go. Actually, a person in the middle of where a plane would land or take off. Sort of aimlessly walking in one direction and then the other. The planes are real and then not real. So you can't be hurt in the scene, and no planes ever truly land or take off, but they're the planes of your mind. They're like planes inside of your mind, and you are in a scene. This is really inspiring energy within your heart portal. I can feel it actually glowing. But it's only a tinge. It's only a tickle of energy. It's just enough to feel. Just enough to take notice. Again, putting this window is again the scene inside the brick room, and even smushing the face against it, trying to see through it. I see an aged version of you from what would be an 8-year-old to maybe a late 20s. There is something in the way of feeling uncertain of whether to be childlike or an adult. Wanting to be silly sometimes, but then wondering what the point is. This window does act like a mirror, because you can see your own reflection in it, but it's not a true mirror, it's literally a window. They say, if this is the window to your soul, what would you see in the reflection? What would you see about yourself? And if you could discover, you could step inside of the mirror and actually find yourself within your own reflection, would you actually go that far in order to do it? Do you want to know what truly is on the other side of the mirror that is you? Are you ready to discover that part or aspect of yourself? I can't give you the answer to that. Only you can decide the answer to that. But they do indicate that you are absolutely ready to explore this. There's the gravity of reality involved here. When you choose to take this journey, you will never be able to go back to that room ever again. You will never be able to go back to the cold walls that felt like home. The cold walls that felt like home that kept you safe, so to speak. Where everything just could be whatever it was meant to be, and then if it disappeared, it didn't really matter. Only when you choose to step through that gateway and see into yourself and discover who and what you truly are, now can we start revolving you past this brick room with no doorway in and out, that you wouldn't even care if there was one. You are still, in a sense, the lonely child looking through the window at the airport, and nobody is actually looking back at you, and the planes, too, do not see you. Nobody sees you. And now you, too, are just a reflection in the glass that nobody pays notice of. But if you truly see the value within yourself, then now you must choose to say that that is what you choose to see. Or you can just fluff it off and just say, well, I feel my value on the inside, but I can't really access it for some reason. You have to state what it is that you know, and now you have to stand firm with it and continue to build your life around that. No wishy-washiness in between the seams of it. We all do this. We all have a wishy-washy way of identifying what it is that we are, or the projection of ourselves, but then still feeling human, right? Still feeling sort of stuck in the humanness and not really knowing how to move past that. There's an airport chair you're sitting in. There's sort of the, I don't know what those, they're not escalators, but they're moving pathways, right? They're going on behind you. You're even smaller now than before. You're more like 4 years old. And your interest is in a book that you would like to read. Everything seems like a blur around you. The people passing by, you seem to have eyes in the back of your head, like you could see in 360 degrees. Like your head is a sphere that sees in all directions. But you're trained or asked to only see straight ahead and not to choose to see behind you, although you are perfectly capable of being able to see in on 360 degrees. You're even telling me that all human beings have the ability to see behind them. Self, in and above themselves and below themselves, they don't have to use their human eyes to see. If they would only discover that their soul is the all-seeing eye, now they can see in every single direction, in between dimensions and in all times and places. This 4-year-old version of yourself is taught and trained to suppress the all-seeing eye, and now to only look forward, because that is the only way that is appropriate in order to see. Human beings do not choose to see what is behind them when their eyes are in the front of their heads. This is absurd. Parents making it very firm that you need to see straight ahead. Do not see in 360 degrees. But yet you still can, and you feel like you are in a blur or a state of confusion. You're interested in this book, but you cannot deny that you see 360 degrees. You can see a man walking behind you. You can see this walking pathway. You can see all the people sitting in this airport waiting for their plane. You can see out the window. You can see to the side. You can see your parents all simultaneously in one single instant. It's kind of a smudgy blur as you take in all the scenes around you in a single instant. And now you're just sort of, coming back to yourself, and now you're feeling human again, and then you're just choosing to try to be like mom and dad. Things feel really blurry and foggy again. They feel fuzzy. There is a vulnerable sensation you feel within your heart. You're uncertain again. You know that you're different. This little girl is on the other side of this window or mirror, whichever you want to, however you want to define it. She is asking if you would like to come into her world, if she could merge with you once more, if you could discover your true capabilities or your true powers. But are you ready for that? She shows me a version of you turned upside down and hanging and sort of walking on the ceiling, but so more so feeling like you're being hung up by your feet, and the blood rushing to your head, and feeling life turning upside down. She says, are you able to handle this? You want to stretch your senses. You actually show me yourself stretching your senses and even stopping the essence of of time reality, and even stopping the ability, the aspect of gravity. So you stop everything, and you're the only moving particles. So you stop all atoms, all reflections of time, all dimensions, everything. You just put the video on pause, and you're the only moving particles. And so you actually move your entire body out of this sort of noose that your feet are hung up in. And then you go and sort of land on your feet. But you have the ability to stop everything. And then be in control of all the dynamics of the creative reality. And this version of you is quite certain you know who and what you are, and you feel so incredibly powerful that this behavior as a human being just seems utterly absurd. In fact, it just seems so absurd that now you're able to reconstruct your entire world. But now the old version of you, the human version of you, is returning, and you're feeling confused and lost again, and you're not really sure what's going on. And you just prefer things to just look one way, and let's just keep it like that, because I can't really relate to that other person, because that other person is, I don't know how to maintain or hang on to that version of superness 24/7, and I can't go weaving in and out of it, or I'm going to lose my mind. I either need the reality to be this way, like a human being, like mom and dad, or if it's going to be the other way, you need to just stay that way. It's a fading in and out of one reality and into another. But they're not saying reality, it's the same reality, but discovering what your true potential is within the confines of a reality. Discovering there are no confines, because there's only an infinite exploration. Being able to control atoms and particles and the willpower of time itself. This girl is still asking you if you would choose to walk through the portal to come to her. The human version of you says, there's no way in. This is just a piece of glass. The other version of you is well aware of what its potential is and has no need to even walk towards the girl, because she knows already that the two are in oneness. She is you. Therefore, the girl now is within your room in this space as the total version of you. While simultaneously, the human weakened version of you is also in the space. Now, you are both looking into each other's eyes. This little girl is aged version of you, and you are both looking into each other's eyes. The human version of you is very vulnerable. It's scared all the time. It doesn't know how to step into that persona. It's scared of what that would be like or what that would mean. You feel quite a lot of fear about it. This other persona is patient, and it sees you as weakness. It sees you as complete and utter weakness, and choosing weakness as a safety blanket, as though weakness is going to make you feel better. This other version of you does not tolerate weakness, but yet it also understands in that way that it will not blend with the weakened version of you if you are not ready for it. It would not do that to you. You ask this version, your human version, asks this super version, are you really me? When I look at you and touch you, you're actually me? This other version doesn't have to say anything, because you are discovering who and what you truly are by asking questions and looking into your reflection and now seeing your value and your worth. There are constant blips where it's almost like an instantaneous scream or sound, and then it just gets swallowed up and goes away very quickly. Sometimes I'm sort of going into the sound, and a version of you is sort of in a state where it's like really loud noise, and you're like, ah, like this, in a constant state, feeling overwhelmed by a very loud noise. I'm just waiting here. I'm overriding that so that can quiet down. It's very difficult to override it. It's very difficult to. I am trying to help you discover that the sound is not real, but you are insistent that it is real and therefore it is the truth. So for me to help it go away, I have to convince you that it truly is an illusion. There's some anxiety associated with this. There's anxiety associated with you discovering who and what you truly are. Therefore, it's better for you to not discover that. Because the anxiety, you feel vulnerable, you can't see the future, you don't know what is going to happen. It could be very terrifying and terrible. That is just the ego. That is the ego saying it's better to be stuck in a room full of bricks where you can, nothing really matters. The ego doesn't want you to discover who and what you truly are because the ego does not know how to process that. It freaks out. It freaks out based on that. And so right now, the anxiety is only associated with the ego. Basically, the ego is screaming and tormenting you to feel suppressed. So you will stop this behavior. You will stop this madness. It's like the parents telling you to stop this madness. You just look straight ahead. Stop thinking you can look everywhere. You can't look everywhere. You can only look straight ahead. The ego says you can only look straight ahead. Stop thinking that you can do all of this stuff that's absurd. And because it's so absurd, I'm going to make you pay for even thinking that you would have the right to consider yourself awesome. That's the ego. The ego does that to everybody. That's why human beings feel this big, because we let our egos make us feel that big. The ego is scared all the time. The ego doesn't understand infinite totality. The ego doesn't believe we have the ability to just stop time and, you know, control the particles and become some superhero. The ego does not want that. If that's the truth, then what does that mean? What does that actually mean? This is a big deal. It's still too loud, you say. But I'm saying, if it's so loud, your eardrums would be burst and your ears would be bleeding. Say, there's no pain, there's no nothing, there's no breakage of the ears, there's nothing. You can hear me just fine and you understand me just fine. Allow yourself to let go of this foghorn noise. It's like, like in the ears, constantly like that. So there is none. You can hear me just fine. Your ears aren't bleeding. There's no pain in your ears. It is an illusion of the mind. The ego is making you believe that you are this big. And this is actually as big as you should be. And this is normal. And this is the best way to live life. And this is the safest way to live life. And just blend in like the other sheep and don't be your awesomest self. Don't actually think about thinking that you're even awesome, because that would be absurd. Because you're actually this big. And this big people aren't, you know, don't need to be bigger than that. This is helping you immensely. The sound is going away and you're starting to, the agony is reducing and you're coming to yourself now. This is huge. This is very huge for you, okay? I know this is all seems like a storyline, but I'm doing energy work in your spiritual atmosphere, helping the reflection of you that feels drowned out by the sound of your own ego, inspiring you to feel this big. You know who you are on the inside, but how do you access that? I have to get that ego noise to quiet down so that you can actually step into who and what you truly are. You're going to feel different after this energy work. You may even notice that things feel quieter than you've ever noticed before, and it's going to be a strange thing for you. Spirit wants you to discover that you have access to very high vibrational wisdom. They call them high vibrational thoughts because you would think they were merely thoughts when in all actuality, you are a radio that is accessing frequencies of information at very high realms of wisdom. Extremely high, high up, golden, super, the highest realms of heaven type of thing. You have access to super high frequencies that would like to communicate with you, but they have not been able to access you because your ego has been screaming in your head and not allowing you to quiet that sound so you can actually do what you were called to do in this life. This version of you is standing up and you are coming into your own as though the on button just got, you know, that we flipped the light switch and now you are, you know, I know me. I know who I am. I know what I am here to do now. They even show me you in a white dress walking forward almost like in a hypnotic daze, but it's only hypnotic because you know who you are to such an insane degree that it couldn't be anything else. And you don't have to question, you don't have to think, you don't have to feel, you don't have to ponder, you don't have to think, you don't have to gaze, you don't even have to use your own eyeballs. You just know. You are in the know. You are I am. You are in the I am expression. You say, I'm ready to access those frequencies now. I'm ready to let go of that persona that I was, the one that was anxious, the one that wanted to stay. They're showing me you already letting go of that to such a degree that only the reflection of your most profound version is the only one we can see. The only truth and the only reality that you are, or that I am. That is you saying I am. The only reality that I am is I am. Coming into who and what you are, stepping into I am, letting go of everything else. There is no need to look for my reflection. There only is my reflection. There only is I am. Even letting go of the walls, letting go of the need to have walls, letting go of the security blanket ego provides, stepping beyond and moving and transcending up into the infinite totality. The frequency of you is going up in frequency in order to access other frequencies. Are you actually going up or are you just tuning your instrument, allowing yourself to open and expand and be in connection with high frequency waves? You can decide. In the scene, you are going upward. As a woman in a white dress, going up, just levitating, flying up like a Superman, but you're just going upward. Like letting go of a balloon and watching it go up. So you are going upward, okay? As you go up, there is some frictional energy that is trying to bob you downward, but you just ignore it because there's nothing that can get in your way now. So that is the truth for you. There is nothing else. There's nothing that can get in my way. We're removing some, I don't know, 1,000 hairs with little balls on them, just pulling them out of the back of your head. We're releasing other and sort of blocked energies, energy blocks in different cavities where we store energy blocks and the backside of the body. There's a weird clamp that was around the entire neck, like strangling you. And so that clamp just came off. You are letting go of all of the sort of drainage. You're just draining all that crap out of you because it's not you anymore. You're feeling completely, breathe in, breathe out. You just feel like even the pores of your body are inhaling, exhaling. You're just feeling completely free. And you are going upward. Continuing to go upward and let go of more facades, more versions of you that inspired you to feel this big so you can be who and what you're meant to be. Who are you meant to be? It's big deal because your frequency is very high. How can you access the high frequency when you still feel the human aspect of yourself? You're letting go of it all. Even new versions trying to show you things. The ego is saying, but look at me, but look at this. Look at this scary thing. Here. Be scared. Don't do it. No! But you're just like, I don't know. Don't know you. Don't have a clue about you. All I know is I want one thing in life, and that one thing is to hear the frequencies of heaven, to feel the frequencies of heaven, and to be the voice of heaven. That is the only thing I know. It's almost on a robotic level where this version of you only has one program, and that program is I am the highest frequency. I access the highest frequencies. I speak the highest frequencies. That's it, period. There is no other garbage, mumbo jumbo, ego, mind-based crap, garbage, human garbage. There is none of that. I can't even believe I fell for all that crap. There only is this version of you. And you're just, that is all there is. I mean, you are like focused. You are just insanely focused. There is nothing else. You just continue to go up. It's amazing. You have surpassed so much. You have gotten through this lesson. You are beyond the lesson now. The lesson is to learn how to be yourself. To be yourself. What self? The human self wants to live inside a box with bricks. No, yourself, the determined one, the high frequency one that knows who and what it is, does what it is called to do, knows its power, is aligned with its power, speaks its power, is power. And it's really super high up. Not everybody can access frequencies like that. If you don't choose to discover, if you don't choose to step into this, humanity is down one guy, you know, one woman, one, you know, one human being. We're one human being down that could access the frequencies and is not accessing them because they feel human. A lot of us are like this. A lot of us are in these shoes, but not you. Not you anymore, okay? Not you anymore, because now you know who you are and now you know what you're meant to do and now you can do it. I'm telling you, I would not be able to see you doing this stuff if you haven't transitioned already. You've already proven to me that in the future, or even today still, or tomorrow, you already will be that. And some reflection of you, you already are that right now. If it was going to be difficult for you to be that, then I would be having a hard time right now in getting through these scenes about you. But I'm not having a hard time because I quieted the ego you registered. It all clicked, and now you are you're on it. You got the scent, and now that's all there is, period. I'm telling you, you're gonna go far. You're gonna go far. You've already chosen to go far. You already chose in your own spiritual atmosphere to go far. So you already are going far. That's me telling you your future. That's me being psychic telling you this is your future. Your future starts already today, or it happens tomorrow, that you're going to actually notice it. I don't know. It is only when you become what you already have chosen to become. Only you can decide what timeline you exist within. So, you are there showing me your frequency is extraordinarily welcomed, and even very large and welcoming arms outstretched towards you. And there's just a little wave of a line that's golden sort of hair that is just making its way upward. But it's a very, very important hair. It's a very valuable hair. Every hair is important. Every frequency is a very valuable frequency. We need all the frequencies. You are getting up there so much higher now than ever before, and you feel like you are walking back into your home again. And you feel that it's been a long time and you've missed it very, very much. You feel a connection with all the other frequencies that you've known for since you were a baby frequency. That's kind of what it's like. Since I was a baby frequency. And we're all sort of hanging out in here. And they're all, everybody, all the frequencies are coming to you. And you're all blending together as one. Just holding each other. And sharing your sounds with each other to retune and reharmonize. And just say, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. I'm thankful, I miss you, I miss you. It's like all these sounds going on. And it's really, really loving. And it just, we're so happy. That's the way it feels. You're so loved. You're so adored. You're so seen. And you're so welcome. And you're revered. And you're important. It's creating a whole lot of energy in my around my head region, a lot of energy in my head region for you. A lot of need to breathe, get a lot of oxygen, and keep breathing and relaxing and just being who and what you are, okay? All right. It is all that I can share for this 30-minute spiritual healing. I'm blown away. I'm totally, totally blown away. It's not every day that I get to share wisdom like this with an individual, you know? And you have a lot to be proud of. You really do. I can't wait to see how you're doing as the days pass, because this energy work is going to be experienced by you. There's no doubt about that. Just quieting that loud noise in that room alone is going to... you're going to notice it. All right. So that is all I have to share, okay? Thank you for exploring this work with me, and thank you for sharing it too for others to experience, because what you've shared with me, a lot of us can feel this way as well, and it's really important that we get to the bottom of why so many of us can feel this way, and who are we truly underneath the skin, and what truly have we come here to accomplish? Do we accomplish just, you know, working an average job and just being an average Joe, or are we actually being called for something much more extraordinary than we ever could have imagined? Now start discovering that the most extraordinary thing is you. And that is what you are called to be. You, the most extraordinary thing, that which is you. You see? All right. So that is all I have to share. And for those of you watching, if you're interested in experiencing spiritual healing with me, I would love to connect with you and help you in your life. Please visit my website at abbynormalswisdomquest.com. Thank you for watching, and thank you for supporting my channel.